Good afternoon. I am Jayla Willingham from Westlake Community Services, located in Ward Price Hill. I am the volunteer coordinator and Westlake Links coordinator at my placement. Getting started, when I first started at Public Allies and I got placed at Westlake Community Services, I didn't think that I would be able to fulfill my position there. Seeing as I've never been a volunteer coordinator, I've never coordinated anything. All I've ever done was work up under other people. So coming on, I was a little worried, I was a little anxious. I've never worked with seniors. That's our mission at Westlake, to keep seniors and homebound in the home independently as long as possible, providing meals on wheels, transportation, and home care. So I was a little worried about that as well. My demographic has always been children. I've never worked with senior citizens, so I was worried that I wouldn't be able to do that either. But coming along, it was easy. I went in with flying colors. Anything I didn't know, I was open to learning. I was a little intimidated at first because, like I said, I had no experience. I was intimidated stepping into Public Allies because a lot of you all have college degrees or have more college experience than me, which I only have 1 year of college. So I thought of that too, that that would be a downfall for me. But stepping in, especially with my team service group, they encouraged me in our gift seat, which is an opportunity for us to give feedback to one another. They encouraged me to speak up more, to take the skills and the assets that I had to utilize and to make our team service project better, as well as my placement better at Westlake Community Services. So that was a great experience. And then when I came in as well, I thought that if any of you all wouldn't relate to me or understand what it was that I felt about something, that nothing was wrong with me, something was wrong with you. Being put into our training spaces every Friday with so many different, unique individuals, and to hear everyone's different stories and why it is that they feel the way that they feel about different experiences was a wake-up call for me that nothing's wrong with you all, but that we are all different individuals, and that's okay. Our experiences, our upbringing, the way that we were grown, that makes us into who we are, and that we all have different assets and skills to put into place so that we all can make the world in Cincinnati especially a better place. One thing that I noticed that I did in our mid-year retreat, I found myself like mimicking my environment. I would come in, if I was hanging with Erica, it would just be like, what do you want to do, Erica? You want to go paint? Or something like that. So it was just like anything anybody else wanted to do, I wanted to do that. And I had to stop myself and step back and ask, Jayla, why are you doing that? What is it that you like to do? And it was just like, from high school throughout my first year in college and everything, that's what I spent my time doing. So when I realized that, it made me want to be by myself and question more, and to get to know myself more. I still had questions. I still didn't know why I did the things that I did, but I did want to venture off and just figure out what Jayla likes. So when we did our Myers-Briggs training, which is just an assessment of yourself, one of the characteristics that I had was adaptability. And that showed me, because I thought maybe I was a follower, but that showed me that I'm not a follower, that I'm an adapter, and that adapting is not a bad thing. It is a good thing, but you have to learn when to adapt and when not to adapt, when it's appropriate to be yourself and when it's appropriate to go ahead and adapt, not because I want you to accept me, but because I want you to feel comfortable around me and that maybe we can come together and compromise and figure out a solution. If there's something that I feel like you don't understand, maybe us sitting down is happening, I can get you to understand why I feel the way that I feel, or the same way, vice versa. Also, when I started, one of my main focuses was money. I was a very materialistic person. I worked 3 different jobs, not because those were the things I enjoyed doing. I just wanted money. I figured if I wasn't going to school, why not spend my time getting money? But it's like during our team service project, like you all saw over there, all of the different projects that we did, as well as our service days, Make a Difference Day. We actually had to take a Saturday where it wasn't our Monday or Friday schedule, and actually donate our time. And I found that in doing that, I really enjoyed myself. I enjoyed the feeling of being able to help another person who might not have the resources and tools that I have. So that was a great experience for me. That changed my outlook on anything that I want to do as far as career-wise. I don't want it to be monetary. I don't want it to just be, oh, you're a pharmacist and you can make this many figures. I really want it to be something that I enjoy doing this, so when I do it, that I know that I'm giving from the bottom of my heart and I'm not just doing it to get a benefit out of it. The other thing that I learned when I came in, I always wanted to help other people. I always wanted to give from myself. I would literally take from myself. So coming into Public Allies and being put on the form and being able to see all of the different nonprofit organizations that we have in Cincinnati and how I could connect people to those resources instead of taking from myself, that was an awesome opportunity for me as well. And it just showed me that I can connect people and that I don't have to physically take from self, but that's still helping a person with what they want to do. And with that being said, like I stated before, I thought other people were different and everything, and that you all were crazy. You're not crazy. I do want to encourage you all to be yourself. I told you all in my mid-year presentation of learning that I'm still learning myself. I'm still working with myself. If you don't know yourself, that's okay. I just want to encourage everyone to be yourself because being you definitely makes a difference. It definitely made a difference for me. And I'm going to dance with you all by Read All About. It's about what we see, and it's called Read All About.